3 week night at 8. And coming up this week, I've got a couple of nights when I'll be playing the very best of the new releases. And at the start of autumn, there's always quite a pile to choose from. But this week, it includes music from this little-known Czech composer. He's called Antonín Rajchina, and his music is currently getting a bit of a dusting down. Listen to this. Then there is more on the Full Works concert with me at 8 o'clock coming up this weekend. That's a get there. Playing the music of Rajchina. You heard the finale of his violin concerto in G with the soloist Jana Chitilova and a musical finale conducted there by Marek Strum. Now here before 3 this Sunday afternoon, I'll play you teenage musical experiments and we'll do some climbing ladders before 3 on Classic FM.
Sunday afternoon on Classic FM.
With Downton Abbey on ITV1, the second series begins on Sunday the 18th.
Here's a little bit more. The price of your current Sky package is now frozen for a whole year. So while the cost of other bills keeps going up and up, it's nice to know that the price of your Sky package will stay the same until at least the end of August 2012. Price freeze. Just one of the many things we do for our customers because we believe in better. To find out more, go to sky.com/enjoymore. Not applicable to offers and other exclusions apply. Residential customers only.
You've got to be honest. Life's pretty good at the moment. Here you are, taking some time out to enjoy some of the finest classical music. But what if something were to happen which made life altogether more complicated? You'd want everything to get back to normal as quickly as possible. If you've been involved in a car accident that wasn't your fault, and you've been injured, the Ballroomy Partnership will use their 30 years' experience to help you get the maximum compensation you deserve, ensuring the process is quick and stress-free. Talk to them today. If you're the 12th accepted case this week to go in Vienna, we'll treat you to a classical weekend away. Call the Ballroomy Partnership at 8-8-8-5-8-8. This is Classic FM.
symphonies. The early ones, for sure. It's the music of Mendelssohn in the String Symphony No. 2. Concerto Cologne played the opening movement of Classic FM. Thank you. Rossini, and the overture, The Silken Ladder, who is played by the Sinfonia Varsovia, conducted there by Yehudi Menuhin. I'm handing over to the man in the H's. It's Alex James next on Classic FM.
Sunday afternoon on Classic FM.
With Dan Tonelli on ITV1. The second series begins on Sunday the 18th.
Greatest film scores, played by the legendary London Symphony Orchestra. And they're yours to own, free, with the new issue of Classic FM magazine. Plus, as well as one free CD of favourite film themes, the new issue of Classic FM magazine comes complete with a second CD, a piece at the heart of the acclaimed film, The King's Speech, Beethoven's Symphony No. 7. Issue of Classic FM magazine with two free CDs out now.
This year, Chevrolet celebrates 100 years of great cars. Hail from the 10th to the 18th of September 2011. Our centenary event is your key to some great offers, like a sparkling new plus sneaker from $6,995, or the new Mercedes hatchback with 6 LS for just $2,995 for the 5-year 100,000 to a standard. So visit your Chevrolet location and check out the good offers that keep us moving.
Businesses are saying about apprenticeships.
Apprenticeships address the severe skills shortage in our sector.
The flexibility of an apprenticeship means our staff are trained in the skills we need for the future.
Apprenticeships keep us ahead of the game, so we remain competitive.
We'd recommend apprenticeships to any business.
To find out more, let's see if apprenticeships can give your business a fresh approach to grow. Visit apprenticeships.co.uk or call 1-800-1506. Apprenticeships, good for business.
To 9 in the morning when the first hijacked plane hit the Twin Towers.
Since then, we've lived in sunshine and in shadow. And although we can never unsee what happened here, we can also see that children who lost their parents have grown into young adults, grandchildren have been born, and good works and public service have taken root to honor those we loved and lost.
There was a poignant recital of the American national anthem, The Star-Spangled Banner, by the Brooklyn Youth Corps. The service is continuing with the reading of names by relatives of the near 3,000 victims.
Stephen J. Candelosi.
Lisa Bella Canava.
A remembrance ceremony is also taking place at the Pentagon in Washington, where 184 people died. Here, 2,000 worshippers packed St. Paul's Cathedral in London, where prayers were said for all the 9/11 victims, including the 67 Britons. Ahead of a planned ceremony in a special garden beside the U.S. Embassy, protesters have set fire to an American flag during the minute's silence outside. About 100 men from a number of radical Islamic groups shouted USA terrorists and brandished anti-American placards. A group of about 60 supporters of the English Defence League, who gathered in response to the demonstration, scuffled with police as they were moved to a different part of Grosvenor Square. In America, the day will culminate with an address by President Obama, will travel to the Pentagon and Shanksville in Pennsylvania, where planes were also brought down. In other news, 77 U.S. soldiers are among more than 100 people wounded after a suicide truck bomber struck a NATO base in eastern Afghanistan. A 3-year-old girl was one of 2 Afghan civilians killed in the attack, which the Taliban said in Kabul. 3 men and a woman who live at a caravan site in Bedfordshire have been arrested on suspicion of slavery offences. Police suggested some of the 24 men they were moving from the Green Acres site in Leighton Buzzard were being powered against their will, some for as long as 15 years, in poor conditions and forced to work for no pay. Most have English and Eastern European backgrounds. England's cricketers have been set a competitive target of 281 to win the fourth one-day international against India at Lourdes. The German driver Sebastian Vettel has won his eighth Formula 1 World Prix of the season in Italy. Prince Jensen came second and Lewis Hamilton fourth. And the weather, windy, especially in the northwest, with gale force gusts in exposed areas. Spells of sometimes heavy rain will affect parts of the northern UK, but drier and brighter to the southeast, with scattered showers and sunny spells and highest temperatures of 20 degrees. Classic FM. It's 3 minutes past three.
The award-winning A to Z of Classic FM music with Alex James.
Good afternoon, Alex James here with the Music Encyclopedia. All your favourite music, all in your favourite order, i.e. alphabetical. First up this week, Swedish trumpeter Håkan Hardenberger. Born in 1961, studied in London, Malmö, Paris. Principally
although you can also throw in musical director, conductor, arranger, you name it. Born in Newcastle in 1956, musically speaking, he was a clarinetist first in the Coldstream Guards, I guess. This is the chap who graduated from the Royal College of Music with a mark of 100%. Let's hear it. straight paraphrase, this is Alex James and the A to Z of Classic FM Music. Thank you. Tchaikovsky, the Polonaise Brillante, performed by Lila Yosefovich and the Academy of St. Martin and the Fields at the Neville Mariner. Threw that in as an example of harmonics. Funny like this, okay, if you imagine hearing any notes, what you're actually hearing is a bunch of notes. We hear them all together, which is we see a colour. It's a natural fact, it's a blend of a number of colours, but musically speaking, you can produce all the constituent notes separately. On a string instrument, it's particularly easy. If you touch the string very lightly rather than holding it down, at various points along its length, it will produce what we say called harmonics. Any parents of a string music learner will know them very well. Okay, H for harmonics, H for harmony. Easier one, this. If you imagine melodies as the horizontal line of music, then harmony is the vertical chunk. The chords, that's it. Really easy melody. And very much with just one instrument, the cello. short and sweet. Let's go backwards and main course.
Thank you.
part of Haydn Symphony No. 30, the Alleluia Symphony, performed by Concertus Musicus Vienna, under Nicholas H. for Encore, Austrian, originally a cellist, but now known first and foremost as a conductor, specialising in period performances. After a long stint as an industrial cellist, he founded the Concertus Musicus Vienna. In terms of professorships, he's headed up the Mozarteum in Salzburg since 1972. Oh, one other thing, he's a count too. Count Nikolaus de la Fontaine und Donald Korn, the Zarks, in Salzburg. He traces himself well back to the Habsburgs and Emperor Leopold II. Let's hear him again. Thank you. Handel's Concerto Grosso, the B flat, Chantus Music is here, Nicholas, my name is James, I'm ICFM, and it's an angelic pitch.
Just for the school.